Dun, 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 dun. Alright, how's it going, folks? He's a wee sound. Just trying to fix the sense here, things are a bit too bright. He's a sec. He's a sec. Give us a sec, just... How's it going? Do I get you in? Quinn? Well, I found it in deep heat. I'm looking rough. Kieran says I'm looking rough. I look rough. Do you know that song, eh? Home encounter bit the other week. You look rough, Lim Job, says Marty. Lack of sleep. No, this is me, this is me. This is what I look like when I'm not getting propped up with makeup and all the rest of it. This is what I look like. This is actually me. I'm not actually looking rough. Me on my show. That's me looking good. That's not me looking normal, that's me looking good or no rough. Well, I don't know if it looks good, but gooder. What do you think of people freewheeling Franklin says, do you like Strawberry Switchblade? Yep. What do you think of people, is cleverer a word? I've always been taught that cleverer isn't a word. No, right, but then I found it on some online dictionary. Maybe it's an American dictionary though. More clever. Aye, I thought so. Why do people get all fucking like more clever? I remember saying to somebody about a year ago, I was in a company of two people, and I said to one of them, I'm thinking I tried to do something cleverer. Is that a word? And they said, well, it is now. I went, alright, what is it, more clever, right? Try to do something more clever, right? And I went away and I thought about it and I thought, oh, it is now. I thought, what's up with that? What's up with cleverer? What's up with cleverer? What is up with cleverer? What is it, Miss Electro? There's nothing up with cleverer. Is that another person saying I look rough? Look, I've not had a shower, I've not washed today, I've not done anything, right? It sounds like a 2-year-old retard, right? I know it's more clever, but what's up with cleverer? Because it's not like you're saying, I think, you know why I think people get all fucking uppity, and I get up with you about fucking spelling and grammar and that. But I think the reason why people go that, if you say cleverer, is because they think you've just said something like betterer, which is daft because you've already said better. To say betterer is stupid, right? But that's not what cleverer is. Clever is the word clever. More clever, cleverer. Is it because it ends with ER? Is it because it ends with ER, so something R? Aye. Stupid says more cleverer is wrong, right? Cleverer is okay. That's what I think. More cleverer it's stupid. You've already said more, the ER at the end, that's like, and Gooder, I know, Gooder, people have got a bit of a problem with fucking Gooder. I never say Gooder, mind you, but good, that something was good, this is Gooder. Gooder. Some people will be asking is, what's the mix, the version of Come On Let's Work that you've got on your show? And I like to be a smart listener and go, it isn't a version of Come On Let's Work, it's Helium Halib by Capella. It's not a version of anything, it is what it is. They're thinking of this, they're thinking about this one. Come on, let's work it to the bone. Original. Come on, let's work. I think they're that. I like to be a fucking arse about it, man. I like to be a right arse about it, man. What version of Come On, Let's Work have you got? Didn't use any version of Come On, Let's Work on my show, I don't know what you're talking about. The one where you've got the keyboard. What version of Come On, Let's Work have you got? I don't recall using Come On, Let's Work. Any version? I don't recall that. Don't have any recollection of that event. That's what you say when you've been caught out, isn't it? I have no recollection of that event. That's what you say, don't you? That's what you're meant to be. That's what you're told to say in court, isn't it? That's what you're told to say in court or in interview room, was it, interrogation room. I have no recollection of that event. See, when I look at this, and you've ever seen Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, you know that bit where they get like Snake Surprise and all them fucking beetles, that bit where he lifts up a fucking, the guy opposite the woman lifts up a big fucking beetle shell, eats it and goes that. Blech. That's what that looks like right now, doesn't it? Blech. Oh my god! Chillest monkey brains! Oh my god! Is he nuts? What bit's that? Big Harry gets it, that's the bridge bit. Hey, Shorty! He tang tong sang zingong ja! Oh, hey! What did he say? We're gonna go for a ride, lady! Oh my god! Is he nuts? That's Steven Spielberg's wife, did you know that? Then my girlfriend Lynn calls me a tramp and a Ned, because here's how I eat my yogurt. Right, there's my yogurt, right? She's instead of going like this, I do this. I just dip it in. Right? Just kind of go like that. In fact, I even like going like that. I like just touching it with the back of the spoon. Because it's so tempting to just fucking pan the lot at that. Bang, man! Because it's not like real food, it's not like fucking. It's. You could drink that, I could down that about 30 seconds. Just have to make it last. Now it goes back to my roots in Carmodrick. Very, very rough council estate on the south side of Glasgow. We were poor. Poorer than poor. So this used to make the yogurt last. But yous all did, didn't yous? Yous all did. I used poor. I wasn't actually that poor. I wasn't that poor. Chrissy says, in last week's show, were you in the Maryhill Club?
Yep.
Maryhill Juniors Football Club. Used it in the first series and the pilot. You know the bit where it's got the kind of burgundy seats? Jacqueline, Kaylee, that kind of thing, that's that. What's that? Yes. Hmm. She calls me a tramp and an Ed. She thought it was a Ned for day one. Met my girlfriend and Nutty says chav bastard. Nutty, where are you from, mate? Let's get it sorted. Armadale, where's that? Armadale, that sounds familiar. Bathgate? Armadale? No, I thought it was Manchester because it was like, is it not like the Armadale Centre or something? Bathgate? The Dale Man? Armadale? What? Shithole next to Bathgate. Right, what are you doing? We've established a Scottish and what are you doing saying chaff? Why are you saying chaff? It's Ned. We've already got a fucking word, Ned. Ned! There's even a film out right now to remind you. Ned's. Fucking hell, man. If we're not busy trying to be Americans, we're busy trying to be fucking English. We've got a fucking word! Not it says, aye, chav winds you up, but you're a fucking liar. Don't try and play the fucking troll card. I got you. I knew that would wind you up if I looked like a fucking idiot. I knew that would wind you up if I came across as a fucking idiot. Haha, I got you. Anyway, aye. Met my girlfriend in a web company in 1999. No, in fact, 1998. And for a moment she lay dies and she thought, he's a wee Ned. And I like to say to her, doing alright for a Ned, innit? I like to remind her of that now and again. Doing alright for a Ned, innit? Haha, what does that mean? Well, just like a kind of bit of an idiot, the clothes I wore, the way I speak, my attitude, people getting fancy sandwiches and that for lunch, I was getting a pot noodle. Doing alright for an Ed though, I think. Doing alright for an Ed. I like to remind her of that now and again. Doing alright for an Ed, innit? Shaker says I'm too good for her. Nah. Nah, mate. Quite the opposite. She's too good for me. Because I'm not. I'm not miserable, woman. That woman, when I was ready for saying naughty stuff that I should be saying aye, she made me say aye. When I was ready to say aye, not that carry on. Is she in the room with you? No, she's next door. Shaker says, is that why the second series was shite? Hold on, Shaker, I'm about to issue you with a wee ban. This is on top of your Facebook ban, so here it comes, mate. What's that name? Keep scrolling up, hold on. I know you're trying to get away, Shakers, the page keeps scrolling up. Hold on, I'll get you though. Now where are you? I'll just scroll up because you said a few things, didn't you? Just trying. There he is, got him, hold on, got him here. Here he is. Oh, they look like the wrong person. Gotcha. and you're out, and you're out, and you're out, you're out. Now I just want to fucking, I want to let Shakers there serve as an example. I knew two of Shaker's brothers in school, right? So I should be giving him a break, but no. I just want that to serve as a, I want him and his Bannon to serve as an example to you. That I don't have any fucking loyalties to any cunt, man. He's gone. He said, is that why your second series was shite? He's gone, man. In fact, have you noticed that it's the ones who feel that they're familiar with family members, pals, who think they can get away with saying cheeky things to you? No. Out you fucking go, man. You reach an age, or you just reach a certain frame of mind in your life, where you go like that to everybody. You make the decision in your mind, you don't actually go out and tell everybody right there and then. You go like that to everybody in your mind. I don't care if you're family, I don't care if you're my brother, sister, da, ma, son, daughter. In fact, son or daughter's different. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're my best pal that I've had for fucking 1 year, 10 year, 100 year. I don't care if you saved my life. You come to cunt with me, you're out. And you are out forever. And there is a strength that you gain by saying that to yourself, man. Making that commitment to yourself. There is a strength. You just go on. So it's like, man, you just feel like you're bringing it all together, like that. Do a rap. Belfast says do a rap. Do they still do raps in school? You know, whenever you see like a drama, I don't know if it's an 80s thing, but or a 90s thing. Hey, this year for the school play, to get the message across, we're going to do a rap. The teacher gone like, we're going to do a rap. Do they still do that, or is that, is it something else now? That's dance competitions now. All right, right. Poetry slams. A poetry slam. That's not real, is it? Here, see that person just said poetry slam. I don't know if that's real or not. Right, you get served. Right, I get served. I know I get served. I get served for like cans of Diet Iron Brew and things like that, when that's what I want. Wait, I get served? What? What was I going to say? I remember, like, you know how somebody said to me there, poetry slam, and I'm like, are you serious? And then they could say, I am serious, or, no, I'm only kidding, I don't care either way. But I remember one instance when somebody, I nearly actually freaked out once. I mean, I nearly ran out of building just because I didn't understand what somebody was saying. Have you ever felt that? I don't know if I would call it a panic attack, but I didn't really get if somebody was joking about something in work once. They weren't winding me up, they weren't like slagging me, I mean, but I started feeling that. Ba 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 says that's boring, let me be funny. Watch this. Right, you're gone, mate. Now let me see. Right, there's some people laughing, so that's funny. That's funny. okay, and it's funny.
McAvoy's got the right idea. This is not boring. He's got the right idea, right? I was in work. It was the same work that I met my girlfriend, and there was a guy called Aaron Harper. Do you, and you know the magazine? What's it called? Vibe. It used to be called Clash. Was it that way around? It's called Clash now. You know Clash magazine. Right. The editor. A Clash magazine's younger brother I used to work with him, right? And I was hung out to fuck one day, hung out. And I sat right next to him, right? We're both on the computers and Aaron McLatty's, oh, take a look at this. He's from East Coast, I'm not sure, Fifer. Was it a Fifer? I don't know. But he said, take a look at this, eh? And I looked and he says, aggressive freestyle running. I was like, what is it? What? I looked at the monitor and it was a guy like jumping on things, and this is 1999, I think this was, right? Aggressive freestyle running. Aye, parkour or whatever it's called, that whole fucking thing, freestyle or that, right? But this was fucking before I'd ever fucking ever heard of this. And I was like, free running, aye, and I was like, what? And it just showed you all these pictures of guys like jumping off things. I was like, what? I was looking at it like, what is it? What are they doing? They just kind of jump off things and like go down railings and things like that. And I was like, is that a joke? Are you kidding? No, I'm serious. And I started to feel my fucking mind unhinge. I was like, I can't. What? But it looks like they're kind of, they should have rollerblades or like a skateboard, but they've not. What do you mean? Well, that's what they do, eh? They just kind of go about, and he was kind of smiling, laughing. He's like, that's what they do, eh? They just jump about and just jump about as if they've got skateboards, but it's like, it's not, it's just for the trainers and that. You can buy special trainers that got wee bits at the bottom so that you can slide down things. I was like, Is that you joking, Aaron? You joking? I don't get it. I don't get it. And I honestly had to break off the conversation. I had to kind of go like that. I had to go like that. I had to turn away and turn my back to him and get on with my stuff. I had nothing really to get on with, but I had to turn away from him. I went like and I felt my face getting fucking red. I felt he can see that I'm fucking panicking here. And I'm no joking here, by the way. I'm no joking. Shit. A fucking alcohol induced almost panic attack. McAvoy says, wow, that sounds like a panic attack, mate. No, it was sort of like a panic attack. I don't know if you've ever read my blog, but I've had two paranoid schizophrenic episodes. I think that's what it is. I think I've got, and he's got my DVD for the first series. If you have, you'll know what I'm about to say here. It wasn't drug related, no. See, if it was drug related, it would sort of make sense, but. Who is this fucking? Hold on, who are these people that just typing lots of letters and all that, isn't it? The poster of the Sunflower Panoptics, right? If you've seen my DVD, I think I talked about Dee Dee in the DVD, and I used to just sleep all day. It was between uni and actually getting a job. I just used to lie in bed day fuck all. And at this flat that I used to stay, above the door, there was a picture of two sunflowers. It wasn't Van Gogh, it was just a big kind of 40, you know, a big close up of two sunflowers in a field. And I looked, I never had any inclination to take it down because it was one of the things, you know, above the door there's glass. So anybody through the hall could see into my bedroom, they could see if I was having a wank or anything like that. Not that it would want to, but that's what it was there for, it was to cover it up, right? Now I'm not watching fucking WrestleMania and they're gonna shut up and fucking listen. Imagine that in a fucking pub. I'm talking about something. I'm getting into a story. Aye, so these sunflowers, right? So there's this poster up there. You gonna watch WrestleMania on Sunday? No. Anyway, aye, these sunflowers, what? So I remember waking up one day, don't know what time it was, could have been in the morning, could have been the afternoon, could have been 6 o'clock in the fucking night. I was waking up, don't know, I was looking at the sunflowers and I just didn't feel right in the head. Wasn't it taking anything, I don't even think it was hung there, just like that. I just didn't like the look at it, these fucking sunflowers. I was just like that. I just felt, and you'll know if you've seen the DVD, it was like that. It's like an evil fucking presence. An evil presence coming through these fucking sunflowers. I wanted to fucking tear the fucking poster up. I felt that in the poster it was trying to harm me. There was some kind of harm in the fucking poster. Somebody up there says that's no schizophrenia. Who said that? That isn't schizophrenia. How is it no? I'm telling you that's what that was. Sounds like psychosis, Bill. That is a kind of psychosis, a kind of split for reality, not having a grip on reality. It was a psychotic episode, but it was a kind of paranoid schizophrenic, my mind fucking splitting apart, my mind not being my fucking mind, and getting things in my head. I've watched these programmes on schizophrenics, and just that way of getting stuff in your fucking mind, and you know, I kind of... Too much hash, man. I've never liked hash, not I. Telling you, nothing. Quinn, I think everybody knows that schizophrenia isn't multiple personalities, it's only idiots that think that. Anyway, I was looking at these sunflowers and I was just like that. Just, I wanted rid of them, they kind of meant me harm. And what fucking panics you may with some of that is you're aware of that idea, that concept being in your fucking mind, and that itself fucking gets you fucking scared. Because I'm an intelligent fucking person, I'm quite an analytical person, I look at my thoughts and wonder why I think they thoughts. I think about things I think about, and then I think about them, to go, I wonder why I'm thinking about that, why I'm thinking about that. So I was like, Why is a person like me thinking this? Why is a person like me thinking this fucking mad thought? I just think I'm going mad. And then it just kind of went away, and that was it, and I never came back. And I remember it happened again when I was in, Sydney. But 2005, 2006, Sydney, me and my girlfriend went to travelling, and I was in Sydney, and while we were in Sydney, it may have been Melbourne actually, I was looking at a flyer for some kind of zoo place, and it had all these monkeys over the front of it. I've mentioned it on my blog before, right? It had a flyer with all these monkeys on it. It had monkeys and apes, right, if you want to get all fucking blah about it, but you know the ones that have got tails and ones that have got tails, orangutans, apes, or gorillas and chimps and things like that, right? And I was just looking at it, and it was a nice day and everything. Everything was going well, and I just kind of looked at it, right? And had all of these faces, all of these monkeys, all kind of photoshopped, like one atop the other, all the other place, all in between. So just on the face, just the face there, and then another one next to it. There's a little bit, fucking, like 20 by 10 across, and about that size. All these things. And I think there was like one picture of an orangutan with a fringe. And it kind of, it was like this. And it kind of, the cheeks like that. And it had this fringe, and I thought, it kind of looks a bit human. And then, I think it was either that, or it was something like that, they just sparked me off. They just made me go like that. It was like... Look me think on that. I became scared. Some kind of fear. Was that? An unhinging as if they were I think what I thought was, first of all, what happened was I looked at all these pictures of monkeys and apes and all that, and I instantly had a wee feeling, they look kind of weird. That they look human. But it worried me that they looked human just for a wee bit. There was something not quite right, there was something weird about it. And then that sparked off some kind of chain reaction in my mind that went up dead quickly. It made me feel, And then maybe my mind made a connection, or sometimes makes a connection between something that makes me feel bad and a consciousness behind it. So if I'm looking at this flyer and I'm like, something not right with that, I then project a consciousness on it as if only a thing that can things that can harm me are conscious that they can harm me. So when I look at the flyer, I kind of get this feeling of a two-dimensional fucking print of 40s of fucking apes, a consciousness of them, a feeling that these fucking 40s are these apes. Are able to fucking harm me, able to get in my head. It's kind of like that. It's like my mind, and that's why I think it's like schizophrenia. It's like a schism, it's a shattering of the fucking mind. Like one part of the mind not communicating with another, just fucking goes to pot. Just goes to fucking pot. And I just laugh for a bit. Scared because it just fucking grips you, because you're like, what can you do? You can't physically run away from it. You kind of just battle your fucking head. You just have to ride it out. You just have to kind of go... What? I've came all the way to Australia. I'm travelling. I'm in a really cramped place. And my insanity has followed me here. There's fucking the escape. There's the escape. I'm fucked. I don't know. That sort of thing came into my mind. And then after a lot about... like 30 seconds or a minute, it went. After about that long, it went away. It left. It's really hard to get these fucking bannies comes, man. So. Wasn't it drug related? Wasn't it drink related? Especially that fucking one. Else, it wasn't fucking drinking. Wasn't it nothing at all? Sober for years. Dreaming. Bottle says dreaming. No, I wasn't fucking dreaming. It fucking happened. What do you mean dreaming? Are you sure you were only dreaming? I'm quite sure there was this fucking reality, aye. Quite sure as I fucking stood on the grass, looking at this fucking flyer in Sydney or Melbourne, I didn't have a 5 second dream. Same with the sunflowers. Telling you, it just happened. Wasn't sunstroke, wasn't drugs, wasn't booze. I wasn't going through a stressful time. The first one with the sunflowers, I could have attributed that to too much sleep and it sort of disintegrated my mind a bit. The Australia thing, no idea. The monkeys thing, picture of monkeys coming to get me, no idea. All I can do is put it down to some kind of dormant paranoid schizophrenia. That's what I can put it down to. Just scraped by without getting it. Somehow in the room, whoever it was, just scraped by, man. What, a bullet past my fucking ear latch. Paranoid schizophrenia. Hi, my name's Brian Lemond and I suffer from paranoid schizophrenia. Just fucking miss me. Just miss me, man. Have you got a shrink, Libby? No. Here's what would happen if I ever went to a psychiatrist. They tell me stuff I already fucking know, or they would actually piss me off by making conclusions that I knew weren't they fucking right. That's what would happen. I think the reason why I feel this way is for this reason. I think actually a lot of it is to do with this. No, it definitely isn't, mate. I think it's to do with this. It isn't. What I think it is, look, mate. Have you taken that? Have you drank that? Have you done that? Have you been to that, these places? Have you done that for 48 hours? Have you fucking done all that? Right, you've no. Right, I've done that, then I've no fucking done it. Have you done this? Have you done that? Have you thought my fucking thoughts? How the fuck would you know? Your fucking academic wee fanny just sitting there. You haven't got a fucking clue. This is the sort of stuff you can't fucking learn unless you've fucking been there. People are full of shite. I don't know why I'm getting angry. I've never been to one. I've never been to a psychiatrist. I went to a psychiatrist, there was a counsellor person after I turned my wrist when I was 14 or 15, and after I went for the hospital, that was in Millport, went up the road to Glasgow, and I had to have this meeting where a social worker or something like that, or counsellor or something like that. And she says, why did you tie your wrist? I says, I was just drunk and just kind of attention seeking, and there was a lassie that I thought really liked me and she didn't like me, and I just kind of felt sorry for myself, and I wanted everybody to kind of chase me and try to stop me and help me and all that. I kind of cried for help. Alright, I see. And do you ever feel that you'll do it again? No. Oh, well, that's fine then. Okay, and away I went. A tractor. Cause little did she know that years later I would be poised at the side of the Clyde, ready to jump in. I wasn't really. Well, I said I'd be on till 10, didn't I? Well, I know, say no to slugs. You know when it goes that deep in, you've got to kind of go like that. Because you don't want to put your fingers on it and get off. So what can we talk about then? I was staying until 10:15, and it was done for another 7 minutes. Because I've rabbited on too long about the fucking paranoid schizophrenia. I don't know what's happening with a third series, I don't know. No idea at all. Oh, I mean, Calvin Harris and Katy Perry. In case you know what you're not into that. Katy Perry tweeted, "Well, everybody, UK and Ireland, sorry, but Calvin Harris won't be joining in the fun because he's pulled out at the last minute." Calvin Harris tweeted to all his followers, "I pulled out at the last minute because the goalposts were changed. The production would have been shite. There was nothing, there'd been nothing behind me, no lights, no this, no that. It'd, honestly, it would have been better off with no show than such a disappointment." And then she replied with, "Oh, come on, Calvis. Calvin was the Calvis. Come on, Calvis. The production was okay for Robin," and then named all these other people that have supported her. And then she said another thing. And then that was it. So I'm looking forward to seeing how that goes. Aye, he pulled out at the last minute. He pulled his cock out of his fucking arse, spunked in his fucking face, and then that fucking, what's his name? What's his fucking name? That cunt, fucking magnet knees cunt with a fucking goth haircut. He walks up and slaps all over it. Calvin Harris pulled out at the last minute. He pulled his cock out her ass, spunked in her mouth, and then she fucking puked it onto fucking Russell Brand's shite hair. And then they all shaved it off and they looked pure fucking ugly. That's what happened. If you want the truth, because I'm an insider. I'm a celeb on it. I'm an insider. I'm a celeb. I've not been in the Xbox for ages. You know what I'm actually going to do? You know what I'm gearing up for? I've been playing a single player Black Ops, and then I've heard that the single player's good, but the multiplayer's not that good. People have actually been playing back to Modern Warfare 2. Is that right? Is that Portal 2? So I want to get back onto fucking Modern Warfare 2. Battlefield 3's out, said no, it's like fuck Battlefield, man. Battlefield's shite. Battlefield's shite, man. Here's what fucking happened. Here's Battlefield, right? I went for fucking Modern Warfare 2. It was a laugh. It was a laugh. You got about 80s in the fucking same party, all having a game, all in a fucking headset, all just talking. People I don't even know. People I don't know. They could be recording me, they could be blackmailing me for all I know. But I just go along with people that I say, add me, everybody. Lemmy.com is my username, add me. And then you whittle out the arseholes, you know, people that are kind of coming out with racist stuff, homophobic stuff, people that don't speak at all. You whittle them out, and you end up getting down to like a good bunch of fucking guys that you end up playing with again and again. And they're always falling apart, and they're nice and relaxed, and you can have a laugh with. Scottish Stacey, going to fuck up about your fucking pal Cherie fucking Lauder? I mean, what sort of fucking name is that? Cherie? Fucking hell, man, going to shut up about her. Well, I mean, my pal thinks you're a legend. Right, well, tell your pal, I think she's a legend and all, but you're a fucking idiot for going on and on and on about it, man. Cherie Lauder, how's it going? But your pal's a fucking idiot. Let's see, how did this go then? Let's see. This can go out either way, I'm just waiting to see if it's Lemmy or a dick or... Haha, nice one. What's her name again? I can't remember. Shut it. Alright. I have to shut it. After all that, I have to shut it. We still love you, that's good to hear. I'm just having a... laugh. I'm just having a wee joke. It's just that you did go on about it quite a lot, eh? So I was playing fucking Modern Warfare 2, having a laugh with the same people, with some other people, you know, coming and going and all that. And then people say, get Battlefield 2. Is it Battlefield 2 or is it? Aye, what was it? Battlefield 2? No, is it no? It's Battlefield, no, it's Bad Company 2. It's Battlefield Bad Company 2. Isn't it? Right, Bad Company 2 then. Battlefield 2? No. Battlefield 2 is a separate game. Right? It was Battlefield 2 that I got, right. Is the new one Battlefield 3? Battlefield Bad Company 2. Right, that's what it was, right. Right, so I got that, and I thought, oh good, tanks, helicopters, that's good. But then you've got a team of about 8 people in your party, and they all get fucking split up. I thought there's maybe 4 in your team, that ends up only 3, and some fucking stranger comes in, you've got your people in your party on the other team, and you're like, oh fuck this, man. I'm into the social thing, I'm into the rabbiting away. Because I've got my own personal fucking score. My own personal score. Like, with Modern Warfare 2, I've got my rank, my fucking prestige. I know what's going on. I know where I'm there. I'm at number 30, net 34, rank 34, and prestige 2, right? Let's say I've got that. I know where I am. And then I go into this fucking battlefield, and I'm like, what am I? Like, number 8 or something? What is that? What do I get? What's the weapons I get? What's the fucking... Tell me what I get. And it sort of tells you, but it doesn't tell you. It just doesn't. It's fucking shite. Whereas, what? Prestige is poor, says Smell Your Maw. Just hasn't got a clue. What are you talking about? I'm all about sitting there with like another 7 people on the headset, and we're just rabbiting away and talking about stuff and having a wee laugh. What is it? What's that map in Modern Warfare 2? It's got the kind of, it's like, it's got the wee merry-go-round bit, what's that map? It's not the wee tiny one, it's like Hussies, it's not Carnival, it's got a tiny wee what do you call them? They're like Hussies, aye. It's not Favela. Skid Row, that's it, Skid Row. Cheers, Hunter Boy, Skid Row. Like, you got, you jump on the skid row and you go like that, like, right, fuck it, I'm having a knife round, you know, you've got the Magnum with the tactical knife on it. Is it a tactical knife, aye? And going, I'm going about with my fucking light foot and fucking, is it light foot? Light footed or something like that. And see, that's, I've not played it for that fucking long, I'm like that, fucking, aye, marathon, lightweight, and what's the other one? Lightweight, light foot, I know. And commando, aye. Commando, lightweight, and marathon, and you're just fucking running about that fucking skid row, man. Running about. You fucking, you start at the one that's up there, you know, the wee stairs at the back, you know, that big long bit right at the back. There's the wee stairs and then the big, was it the kind of wee, was it not a path, it's a, the bit at the back. You start there, you run down the stairs, left, take a right, up the fucking stairs, stab, you've got one right up here, up, stab, man, bang, down the fucking stairs, all the way across to the fucking wee corridor, stab, 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 man. And you're telling people, I'm doing good, or I'm doing shite, and all that, whereas with that fucking battlefield, it's just all, are you there? Who's in that? Can you see me? And it's like you're playing with two other people when your other teammates are fucked off. I whereas everybody, nobody knows really what anybody's doing. It's just not a laugh. It's just not a laugh. Nobody uses mics on Battlefield, says, so you know it's love, you're right. A fucking giggle. I'll take a look at Shimmis, I'll take a look at Portal 2. Did somebody say it's a full game? I'll take a look at the advert before I go to bed. It's a full game, is it? Games are pish now, says Smillion though. It just, I've not got a lot of time, I've got my son now, and even though at night I could have a lot of time to play games, I'm gonna intend to play that, but I can't pick up games, play them for hours and put them back down any time I want, like I used to. At any point, everything could be calm, and then there's a time to go and attend to something, so I can't just go out, oh, I'm just gonna play games day in, day out. And then at night time, for me to play games, we're sitting watching the telly, I kind of do that. But now, I'm going to insist. I'm going to say, because like Modern Warfare 2, I've played it before, I can just pick up where I left before. It's not like Black Ops, I'm having to learn this fucking motor that drives about this remote control motor, nobody plays it anyway. But I'm going to go on, man. I'm going to go on. Left 4 Dead 4 is a real winner. I like Left 4... Oh, it's no 4, I Left 4 Dead, I like that. I really like that. I remember I played the single player for Left 4 Dead the first time I got it. And I was like, oh, what's this? Oh, that seems quite shite. What's this? This is crap. Then I played the then I played it with other people. Multiplayer, and I was like, this is fucking brilliant, man. I used to love doing this thing in Left 4 Dead. It would be me, some other guy that I was away, and it would just be the two of us, or maybe it was just three. I think it was just the two of us. And see if a new person came in, like an, especially if it was an American. Nothing against Americans, but it's good winding them up. We'd go like, have you got a mic? Have you got a mic, mate? Have you got a mic? Have you got a mic? If he never had a mic, we'd vote right away to get him kicked off, and he would just get booted right away. But see, we said, yeah, I got a mic, yeah, I've got a mic. We'd let him on, we'd keep him on, and we'd take the total fucking piss on him, man. It was brilliant. We'd just go like that. Hey, let's say it's, let's see your name, Hedgehog, right? We just go on to him, hey Hedgehog, yeah, what is it, buddy? You're a fucking asshole. What? I'm a what? You're a fucking asshole. Why are you saying that? You fucking douche. Hey, shut your fucking mouth. Shut your fucking mouth, you idiot. And just keep saying that again and again and again, man. Shut your fucking mouth, you idiot. And then if they went quiet, if they weren't playing the game, we just fucking kick them off. Penny says, do you hate Americans? I don't, no, but it's just a laugh. I think it's called, what's the word? Bullying, I think it's called bullying. It's called cyberbullying, I think. Don't hate the English either. It's just the thing is, see if you got your headset on and you're Scottish and you open your fucking mouth in front of English or American people on that fucking Xbox, you just hear nothing but can't make out what you're saying. Haggis, whiskey, kilt, just that, right? And it's not even offensive. I mean, there's nothing that a person can say about a Scottish person that's actually offensive. It's not like, don't you ever fucking slag off kilts. It's not like that. Don't you ever slag off whiskey. Don't you ever slag off haggis. It's just that feeling that somebody will just call you a dick again and again. That's all it is. You don't actually care why they're saying it. If you are a dick or no, you're just like, oh, fucking shut up. It just goes run and run and run and run and run. And you can't say it back because they just keep saying the thing about being Scottish. So what you do if you're winding up a Scottish, English or American is you put on their accent. So if there's an English person you wind up, you put on an English accent, or American you wind them up. What I used to like then though was, if I was with an English person, no one in my team, but, and I kind of playing the game with them, you would turn the American on the English, or turn the English on the American by putting on whatever accent you want to be the enemy. Aye, fucking, Pearl Harbor, you fucking American, fucking, fat fucking McDonald's, fucking. Hey, you shut up, you fucking British prick, and I put on an American accent to wind up English. We saved your ass in two world wars. Just keep saying that again. We saved your ass. And then the English will go like that. Oh, Vietnam! Ah, Vietnam! And then what you do is you fucking remove their sword by saying, I don't give a shit about Vietnam. Fuck them. Fuck everyone who went to Vietnam. That's it. You've won that one because you've just won that. I don't care. I don't care about Vietnam. Whatever they say, and then just keep saying, teeth. You British prick. What was that? I used to love saying the same line again and again. The same line. Mr. Flowers, I might do a Shazam in a minute. I used to love just going like that, what was it? It was the same line I'd say again and again. I've heard some English people speaking, just chatting away, there's a sniper up there, I can go up there. I just like to fucking bust in me. Hey, speak English, you British motherfucker, speak the language we taught you. No, is it speak English, you... Speak English, you British prick, speak the language we taught you. Aye, just saying that again and again and again, man. Speak English, you British prick. Speak the language we taught you. Just again and again, man. fucking brilliant. It winds them up to fucking about five or six of them all at the same time. Like, what are you fucking saying? The fucking English, who made the languages in the fucking title? English, who do you think made the language? The fucking English
speak. I can't understand a single word you're saying, you fucking British prick. Speak English, the language we taught you.
Again and again and again, man. What do you mean fucking? What do you mean language, you fucking Tars? We fucking invented you. We fucking discovered you, you fucking, you American fucking. Eat your fucking McDonald's. Go and eat your fucking McDonald's. 9/11, you fucking fat prick.
Speak the language we taught you. I cannot understand a single word you're saying.
Another one I used to like saying was, what was it?
The United States of America is far more powerful than England. Just again and again and again. The USA is far more powerful a nation than England.
Just that, just staying a fact.
Yeah, you're not that fucking powerful, you fucking, you fucking lost Vietnam.
I don't give a shit about Vietnam.
You going to watch it? You know how I've been saying?
I can't understand a single word you're saying, you British prick. Speak English, the language we taught you.
Yeah, I could understand him saying Vietnam. So you got to watch. Fanny boys didn't realise that Joe Pasquale played the Xbox.
Hey, shut up, you fucking... Shot me fucking American prick. Oh, you got me Jacobs. Oh, you shot me in a Jacobs. Oh, you shot me in a Jacobs. Oh, oh shit, my fucking. As I'm skid round, a guy with fucking marathon lightweight and fucking marathon pro fucking stabbed me in a fucking Jacobs.
Right. I'm off ski. I'll see you all later, right? Adios.